टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल डिस्कस एंड गिव लेक्चर ऑन द NBA नेशनल बोर्ड ऑफ एक्रेडिटेशन हाउ द NBA accreditation is done. This is the manual for the accreditation for the undergraduate engineering program, annual undergraduate engineering program, and this is the, we will discuss about the background, National Board of the Accreditation, vision, mission, objectives of the NBA, about the manual by this new stride, Washington Accord, membership of the Washington Accord, signatory of the Washington Accord, provisional status of the Washington Accord, provisional member of the Washington Accord, recognition of equivalence of accredited engineering program, obligation of the Washington Accord, duties of the signatory, path to become a signatory, Washington Accord graduate attributes profile, general guidelines for the preparation of the self-assessment report by the institution, achievement of the PO, outcome-based education, measurement of the program outcome, development of the rubrics, continuous improvement, curriculum development and refinement, faculty members for the program, infrastructure facility, guidelines to the visiting team, in tentative schedule for the visit, do and don't filing in the SAR, 360 degree feedback, self-assessment report, abbreviation, declaration. Part 1 is the institutional summary. Criterion 1, organization and governance, resource, institutional support, development and planning. Criterion 2, teaching learning process. Criterion 3, student admission and the first year performance. Part 2, department, program summary. Criterion 4 to 10, Criterion 4, student performance in the program. Criterion 5, faculty. Criterion 6, facility and the technical support. Criterion 7, continuous improvement. Criterion 8, curriculum. Criterion 9, program educational objective. Criterion 10, program outcome and the assessment. Program educational objective and the program outcome. List of the documents and the records. Evaluation guidelines. Evaluation report. These are the contents of the NBA program. Now come to the introduction. Indian higher education system is the third largest system in the world. In an increasingly technology dependent world, expansion of the higher education sector is imperative. In an emerging society such as India, invest by the phenomenal growth and development in the technical education during the past two decades. The number of institutions has multiplied economically from a modest number of the 30 colleges in the 1950-51 to more than 20,000 colleges and from 20 universities to more than 500 university awarding degree, which include all types of the institution, namely central, state, private, government, aided, deemed to the university and other institute of the national importance. The challenge is to ensure its quality to the stakeholder. Along with the expansion, to meet this challenge, the issue of the quality needs to be addressed, debated and taken forward in a systematic manner. There are the debates across the continent as to who set the standards for the quality. The accreditation system prevailing in various countries provides a measure of the educational quality. Accreditation is the principal means of the quality assurance in the higher education and reflects the fact that in achieving recognition, the institution or program of study is committed and open to the external review to meet the certain minimum specified standards, and also seeks ways to enhance the quality of education. There is a great deal of discussion in the country about the various approaches to the quality management, especially in the context of the unprecedented expansion of the higher education institution and program, introduction of the newer discipline, entry and operation of the four institutions in a variety of the forms and desire of the global recognition through the international accord, WTO mutual recognition, Washington Accord, and the other national protocols. With significant expansion of the higher educational institution in India, both publicly and privately funded, a mandatory and robust accreditation system is required that could provide a common frame of reference for the student and other stakeholders to obtain credible information on the academic quality across institution is required. Through the accreditation process, an agency or its designated representative evaluates the quality of the higher education institution as a whole or of a specific educational program in order to formally recognize it as having met certain predetermined minimal criteria or standards. The result of this process is usually the awarding of a status of recognition and sometimes of a license to conduct the educational program within a time-limited validity. The process can imply initial as well as the periodic self-study and the evaluation by the external peers. The accreditation process generally involves three steps which is specific activity. A self-evaluation process conducted by the faculty, the administrator, and the staff of the institution or the academic program, resulting in a report that takes as a reference set of the standards and criteria of the accrediting body. A site visit conducted by a team of the peers selected by the accrediting organization, which review the evidence, visits the premises, and interview the academic and administrative staff, resulting in as an assessment report, including a recommendation to the accrediting body. An examination of the evidence and recommendation on the basis of the given set of the criteria concerning quality, resulting in a final judgment of the communication of the formal decision to the institution and other constituency, if appropriate. Presently, accreditation is not mandatory and there is no law to govern the process of the accreditation. There are the two central bodies involved in the accreditation of the institution, the NAEC and the NBA. NAEC was set up in 1994 by the University of the Grand Commission to make the quality an essential element through a combination of the internal and external quality assessment and the accreditation. NBA was constituted an autonomous body by the ASCTA. It is expected with the passage of the legislation to provide the accreditation of the higher educational institution and to create a regulatory authority for the purpose. Many of the remaining quality issues will be resolved for some time to come. The spirit of the continuous improvement is a prerequisite for any quality initiative. Educational institutions are no exception to this. ISO 9000 and such initiative focus on the meeting customer expectation and making a wholehearted effort to exceed the same. The process of accreditation is an effort in the direction to meet the quality goals in the education. National Board of the Accreditation, the new education policy of the 1986 recognized the need for the statutory body at the national level responsible for the overseeing the growth and quality of the technical education in the country. Accordingly, All India Council for the Technical Education was established by an Act of the Parliament 1987. National Board of the Accreditation was originally constituted in the 1994 in order to assess the quality competence of the educational institution from diploma level to the postgraduate level in engineering and technology, management, pharmacy, architecture, and related discipline. NBA conducts evaluation of program of the technical education on the basis of the laid down norms. NBA in its present form has come into existence as an autonomous body with the effect of the 7 January 2000 under the AG of the ASCTA with the objective of the assurance of the quality and relevance of the technical education through the mechanism of the accreditation of the program offered by the technical institution. Vision of the NBA. The vision of the NBA to be a world-class accrediting agency by ensuring highest degree of credibility in the assurance of the quality and relevance of the professional education and come to the expectation of its stakeholder these academicians, corporate, educational institutions, government, industry, regulators, students, and their parents. Mission of the NBA. NBA is working with the mission to stimulate and quality of teaching, self-evaluation, accountability in higher education with the help institution, realize their academic objectives and adopt teaching practices that enable them to produce high-quality professionals and to assess and accredit the program offered by the colleges or institution imparting technical and the professional education. Objectives of the NBA. The following are the broad objectives of the NBA to periodically conduct evaluation of the technical institution or program on the basis of the guideline, norms, and standards specified by it. To develop quality consistent system of the technical education where excellence, relevance to the market needs, and participation by the all stakeholders are prime and major determinants. To dedicate for building a technical education system as facilitators of the human resources that will match the national goal of the growth by the competence, continuation to the economic through the competitive and the competitivity with the social development. To provide the equality benchmark targeted at the global and national stockpile of the human capital in all the fields of the technical education. In line with the above, NBA was the mandate to fulfill the following specific objectives of assessing and accrediting the academic program. Assessment and accreditation shall be based on the various criteria. This may include, but not limited to, the institutional mission and objective, organization and governance, infrastructure, facility, quality of the teaching and learning, curriculum design and review, support services, library, laboratory, instrumentation, computer facility, etc., and the, any other aspect as decided by the General Council and the Executive Committee. The main objective of the assessment and accreditation shall be to assess and grade the courses and program offered by the institution by the various unit, faculty, department, etc. Stimulate the academic environment and quality of teaching and research in the institution. Contribute to the sphere of the knowledge in this discipline. Motivate colleges or institution of the technical and professional education for the research and adopt teaching practices that groom their student for the innovation and development of the leadership quality. Encourage innovation, self-evaluation, and accountability in the higher education. Promote necessary changes, innovation, and reforms in all aspects of the working of the college, institution of the technical, professional education for the above purpose. Help institution realize their academic objective. NBA shall ensure that the criteria referred to the above or assessment and accreditation are the reviewed periodically, revised and updated as and when considered necessary on the basis of experiences gained through their application, and accordingly the technique and modality used for the assessment are modified. Objectives and to extend the possible quantifiable and publicized widely, particularly in the academic community. NBA will facilitate to enhance the quality of the technical education and help in establishing relevancy of the technical education as per the needs of the industry and society at large. About the manual. This manual essentially deals with the accreditation process of the undergraduate engineering program. There are three separate documents that have been enclosed here. They are namely self-assessment report with guidelines for preparation of the SAR, evaluation guidelines for the team chair and evaluator, evaluation report to be filled by the visiting team members. Attempts have been made to explain these documents as far as possible in this accreditation manual. Most of these documents are quite straightforward and quantifiable. However, there are few criteria. Sanctions are subjective in nature. For these criteria, the perception, experience, knowledge, and judgment of an individual play the most significant role. The document title, Self-Assessment Report, is basically for the institution. Institution offering engineering program in undergraduate level need to prepare the report as per the format of the SAR. The blank format of the SAR, as appended at the last part of this document, needs to be filled by the institution according to the information asked for. No deviation from this format will be accepted. No change in order of the modification of the format will be entertained. The document title evaluation guideline is essentially a guideline for the evaluator. In this document, attempts have been made to frame a guideline for the evaluation of the SAR submitted by the institutions. The document title evaluation report is the blank report from the evaluator. Once the SAR is evaluated, the evaluator will place the scores in the blank report format along with their observations. Why this new strait Indian education system essentially based on the idea that the good students who were admitted through the rigorous screening process at the time of the admission will become the good graduates provided they have access to the good faculty and the good infrastructure. This education system have been functioning extremely well as there were limited number of institutions in the country and access to these institutions were through very competitive examination. Moreover, Indian students are dedicated and hardworking, but in recent time, there has been huge increase in the number of the engineering colleges and in other institutes, the quality of the output. The graduates of the all these colleges, National Board of Accreditation, New Delhi, has prepared the new document and process for the accreditation, which is essentially outcome-based evaluation system. Washington Accord. The Washington Accord was signed in 1989 and it is an internal agreement among the body responsible for accrediting engineering degree program. In fact, it recognizes the substantial equivalence of program accredited by those bodies and recommends that the graduate of the program accredited by any of the signatory body are recognized by the other body as having met the academic requirement for entry to the practice of the engineering. Washington Accord covers only the professional engineering undergraduate degree, engineering technology, and the postgraduate level program are not covered by the accord. Membership in the Washington Accord. All the signatory have full rights of the participation in the accord. The qualification accredited or recognized by the other signatory are recognized by the each signatory as being substantially equivalent to the accredited or the recognized qualification within its own jurisdiction. A national authority, agency or institution representative of the engineering profession with the recognized authority may accredit engineering program. Signatory of the Washington Accord. The following country are the signatory of the Washington Accord. Australia, represented by the Engineers Australia. Canada, represented by Engineers Canada. Chinese Taipei, represented by the Institution of the Education Taiwan. Hong Kong, China, represented by the Hong Kong Institution of Engineers. Ireland, represented by the Engineers of the Ireland. Japan, represented by the Japan Accreditation Board of the Engineering Education. Korea, represented by the Accreditation Board of the Engineering Education of the Korea. Malaysia, represented by the Board of the Engineers Malaysia. New Zealand, represented by the Institution of the Professional Engineer New Zealand. Singapore, represented by the Institution of Engineers Singapore. South Africa, represented by the Engineer Council of the South Africa. Turkey, represented by the MUDEC. United Kingdom, represented by the Engineering Council United Kingdom. United States, represented by the Accreditation Board of the Engineering Technology, 1989. Provisional state of the Washington Accord. All organizations holding the provisional states have been identified as having accreditation process for the qualification that are potentially suitable for the purpose of the accord. The organization are further developing the procedure with the goal of the achieving the signatory status in due course. Provisional members of the Washington Accord. Bangladesh, represented by the Board of Accreditation of Engineering Technology Education. Germany, represented by the German Accreditation Agency and study programs in engineering and informatics. India, represented by the National Board of Accreditation of All India Council for the Technical Education. Pakistan, represented by the Pakistan Engineering Council. Russia, represented by the Russian Association of Engineering Education. Sri Lanka, represented by the Institution of the Engineers Sri Lanka. Recognition of equivalence of the accredited engineering programs. All the signatory have arrived at an agreement that the criteria, policy, and procedure used by them for accrediting engineering undergraduate program should be comparable to each other. accreditation decision rendered by one signatory are acceptable to the other signatory, it is also agreed upon among the signatory that the all the signatory have arrived at an agreement that a criteria, policy and procedure used by them for the accrediting engineering undergraduate program should be comparable to the each other. Accreditation decision rendered by the one signatory are acceptable to the other signatory. It is also agreed upon among the signatory that will implement the best practices for the academic preparation of engineers. The signatory will have mutual monitoring and information exchange, including regular communication and the sharing of the information concerning their academic accreditation criteria, systems, procedures, manuals, publication, and list of the accredited program. The signatory are also invited to observe accreditation visit, meeting of the any boards and the compromise responsible for implementing key aspects of the accreditation process and meeting of the governing body of the signatory. Obligation of the Washington Accord, each signatory will take the every reasonable effort to ensure that the body responsible for registering or licensing professional engineers to practice in its country or the territory accept the substantial equivalence of the engineering academic program accredited by the signatory to this agreement. The accord applies only to accreditation conducted by the signatory with their respective national or territory boundary. Duties of the signatory, the duties of the signatory are listed below. The signatory will participate in general meeting and the workshop. The signatory will review after every 6 years. The signatory will provide evaluator for reviewing of other signatory and reviewing of the provisional members applying to be signatory. The signatory will also mentor provisional members. Path to become a WA signatory. India became provisional member in the of the WA in 2007. In order to become a WA signatory, a robust accreditation system needs to be implemented by the National Board of Accreditation, New Delhi, with support from the all stakeholders. During the period of the provisional membership, Washington Accord has signed mentors so that the substantial equivalence can be gained in terms of the accreditation standard to the graduate attributes and the policy and process for the accreditation to be substantially equivalent. Reviewers will be deputed by the Washington Accord for the periodic review of the provisional member of the admission to the signatory. All existing signatory must agree 100% of the admission of the provisional member as signatory. Washington Accord graduate attributes profile. Graduate attributes from a set of the individually assessable outcomes that are the competent indicative of the graduate's potential to acquire the competence to practice at the appropriate level. The graduate attributes are exemplars of the attributes expected of the graduate from the accredited program. The graduate attributes are intended to assist the signatory and the provisional member to develop the outcome-based accreditation criteria for use by their respective jurisdiction. Also, the graduate of the attributes good guide body developing their accreditation system with a view to seeking signatory status. The Washington Accord graduate profile is the following: engineering knowledge, apply knowledge of the mathematics, science, and engineering fundamentals and an engineering specialization to the solution of the complex engineering problem. Problem analysis, identify, formulate, research literature, and analyze complex engineering program, reaching substantive conclusion using the first principle of the mathematics, natural science, and engineering sciences. design development of solution, design solution for the complex engineering program and design system of the component or processes that meet the specified need with the appropriate consideration for the public health safety, cultural society and the environmental consideration. Conduct investigation of the complex problem using the research-based knowledge and research method, including the design of the experiment, analysis and interpretation of the data and synthesis of the information to provide the valid conclusion. Modern tool usage creates, select, apply appropriate technique, resources, and the modern engineering and the IT tools, including the prediction and modeling a complex engineering activity and understanding of the limitations. The engineering, the engineer and society. Apply reasoning informed by the contextual knowledge to assess the societal, health, safety, legal, and cultural issue and the consequent responsibility relevant to the professional engineering practice, environment, and sustainability. Understand the impact of the professional engineering solution in the societal and the environmental context and demonstrate knowledge and need for the substantial development. Ethics, apply ethical principle and commit to the professional ethics and the responsibility and norms of the engineering practice. Individual and team work function effectively as an individual and a member or leader in the diverse team and a multidisciplinary setting. Communication, communicate effectively on complex engineering activity with an engineering community and with the society at large, such as being able to comprehend and write the effective reports and the design documentation, make effective presentation and give the receipt clear instructions. Project management and finance, demonstrate knowledge and understanding of the engineering and management principle and apply these to one work as a member and leader in a team to manage projects and the multidisciplinary environment. Lifelong learning, recognize the need for and have the preparation and ability to engage in the independent and lifelong learning in the broadest context of the technological change. Any signatory now needs to provide an overview of its learning outcomes and confirm that the compliance of the program with the attributes in fact being evaluated in the accreditation process. The program outcomes of the new document for the UG engineering accreditation as considered are in line with the Washingtonic Accord graduate attributes.